morning. Okay, we're going to do our workout general program to develop over the period of the course, say 20 days, 20 sessions. Once again, we would have started off on a treadmill to do at least a 5-10 minute warm-up cardio section, then come on to the Vibro Gym, which is already set up for quick start, 60 seconds, amplitude low, frequency 50, and we're just going to go straight into a recovery back massage. So this would be done after a client has actually gone onto the treadmill for 5-10 minutes. So all we're going to do is bring our cushion up, place it next to. I've got my protective mat on. I'm set up to go. I'm going to move my hand grips out of the way just so they're not underneath. I straddle, sit down. So massage for 60 seconds. Press start. Rocking my back. Lower lumbar on. Feet up. You can relax the body. Lower lumbar. You don't have to necessarily tilt the pelvis. Feet can be crossed. Again, we're just doing recovery. And massage for the lower lumbar of the back after you've done your warm up on the treadmill for 5 to 10 minutes, according on your client's needs. So wait for the hips to come down. Change the Vibro Gym Evolution now. So what we're going to be doing now, we've finished our recovery, we've done our warm-up, we're going to do a wide push-up static. So we're going to change the time now to do 30 seconds. So press select, I've got 30 seconds, press select. Scroll down, the amplitude is going to be low. We scroll down to go to the frequency, which again, we're going to have 35. So we're going to press select, 35. So I'm ready to go. I've got 30 seconds for each of my exercises. The amplitude is low, the frequency is 35, and off we go, and we've just completed 1 minute. Okay, so we're going to do the wide, so I'm going to use my full cushion arm here, move the mat out of the way. So it's a wide push-up. I've got my pad on. Mrs. Smith, my beginner, I would only get her to do a box press up and progress it out wider. So my face is over the VG. I can press my start wide, so I'm not narrow, I'm not over the shoulders, I'm wide, and I'm squatting down to hold it. My powerhouse is engaged. My head is in line with my spine. My knees are in line with my hips. If I wanted to do pyramid training here, I could always take the body down to halfway or a little bit lower. But if not static, I can just hold my static position. Breathing in and breathing out. Powerhouse engaged. And release. Come up and just pop the mat back. We're going to do a seated row so I can move my cushion on. Adjust my my hand grips. Again, I'm only 5 foot nothing, so I'm going to have them quite short. If I wanted to do a standing bent over row, maybe after my 6th or 7th session, I could do that. So visual display. I press my start. I'm in. Adjust it. My feet can go up and flat on the floor. I keep the tension in my straps. Elbows are squeezed back, heels on the floor, and my head in line with my spine. And I'm really resisting and pulling and breathing. I've got 15 seconds left. So, I've done a wide push-up. I've done a seated row, static. I'm going to do a plank next, but this is all aimed at the new person. So I'm going to do a plank. So I can move my cushion out the way, my plank position, pressing start. This is my plank, I'm over the platform. I can do narrow starts, medium starts, wide starts. Obviously, Mrs. Smith beginner, maybe I will do take it down to a half and then progress up. Abdominals, powerhouse engaged. Again, from here, if I wanted to change it from static to dynamic, I could do pyramid training or sets of press-ups. Again, here now, we're just doing elbows are soft. I'm doing the plank, breathing in, breathing out. Okay, we're still on 30 seconds. I'm now going to do whole body squat vibration. So I don't need to have my mat on. I wouldn't do whole body vibration, not unless my client has come for at least 12 sessions, and then in the beginning I would bring the mat over and get one foot on and one foot off onto the platform. So whole body vibration, and I'm going to press start. So my feet, I'm in line, 70% or more of the weight is into the balls of the feet, not the heels of the feet, as you can hear my voice. So balls of the feet, distribute it, my knees are cushioned. If I wanted to take it down to a wide squat, I could hold my wide squat right here. Again, the weight is in the balls, I've got 10 seconds. Long body, I could do dynamic if I wanted to. Breathing in, powerhouse, long body, so this is a wide whole body vibration. Once I finish, I'm going to go into a static pelvic bridge. And again, here I can progress all of my moves to take them up, take them down. So, shoulder bridge static hold. My feet are in line with my shoulders. My body is rested. All I'm going to do is a shoulder bridge static hold. Open adjusted. If I wanted to be dynamic, obviously I can move myself up and down. I can do the pelvic Pilates or just rest my hands. So make sure the powerhouse is engaged, knees, shoulders are in line. You're breathing in, you're breathing out. The upper body is relaxed. Weight again in the balls. Once you finish, you can let them squat and roll up, chin to chest, and take yourself off of the platform. Tricep dips is my next one that I'm going to do. So this is quite a dynamic program that can be for a beginner, intermediate, and you could make it into advanced. So again, I haven't changed any of the duration of the time. I can actually, if I wanted to make it harder, do two sets, increase from 30 seconds to 45 seconds. It just depends on my client and where they're aiming to go.